Anyways, Jake, I gotta say something. Let's get to the meat. Fam, you knocked out Tyron Woodley in the most spectacular fashion. I don't think there could be a cleaner knockout. I woke up the next morning stressed because, like, this shit isn't normal. For everyone watching, I want you to, like, know that I will never get over the shock and awe of this crazy fucking life that has found its way in everyone in this room's circle in life. And watching you do that is like watching a fucking movie happen right before my eyes, and I'm your brother. And it's so overwhelming for me to try to comprehend it. Yeah. Because I never can.
Me either. I think the only time I comprehend it is like when I'm like weeks later and I'm like by myself and I just deeply think about it, but it's so weird. It doesn't make any sense. Even Tyron Woodley said it in the post-fight press conference. He's like, you guys are literally watching a movie right now with this kid. And this is insane. Like, we're all a part of a crazy movie. Even when I'm doing the press conference after, I'm like looking at all the cameras and I'm like, wait.
You're the main character.
I'm the main character. This is weird. This is weird as hell. Like,
Mac Bilski, who was once the co-host on this podcast, afterwards, after that press conference, goes, I literally feel like I'm watching a TV show or a documentary film happen in front of my eyes. It was a 10 out of 10 performance delivery. And I don't know, bro. I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of you as a brother.
I felt that from you, and it means a lot because I work so hard to make you proud.
Oh, man.
Because I know a lot of people, like, wanted to see us fail for a while. And that's what drives me in the gym. Because, bro, the shit gets hard. We're both teary-eyed. We're trying not to cry.
Panda Pam.
But, bro, the moment you said, you know, you have to go do this for our family, I really took that to another level.
Now I'm not even in the family.
And when I'm there in training camp, sacrificing everything, you know, time in and time out, I'm just tired. I'm sore and I'm working my ass off, and I have to spar and run and spar and strength and conditioning. You know the drill. But when you do it for a year and a half straight, bro, you need to find extra motivation. And a big part of that is fighting for our family and the people around me and for our name and for everyone who, you know, in 2017 thought that we were going to fall off. And now look, so you could suck our nuts. And that's why I work so hard. I envision that. And I envision just telling, like, being able to flip everyone the fuck off. It feels so good,
bro. You did it in the most grand way, and I thought it was so great during the interview or the post-fight press conference when you talked about you going on vacation for the first time since you were 18 years old, and you really humanized yourself. And it's funny because you haven't had the perfect upbringing and come up, and the world is literally watching the evolution of a human grow in a really natural and really entertaining and captivating way. And if you just watch you, Jake Paul, from a unbiased, objective point of view, I think you're one of the most entertaining people on the planet.
Thank you.
Not just watching a person grow, watching a sport grow, watching a sport change.
I can't believe it.
It's a whole sport through and that's through. Been around for however long, man. Like, actually changing the entire landscape and environment of an entire sport.
Who would have thought? You know, and people like to, you know, put quotation marks around athlete, which I think is the funniest thing.
That's not.
I think it's the funniest thing, but now it's like, what can you say?
The gig's up.
It gigs up.
It's like, you're legit.
Man, we've been athletes since day one.
I was going to say, that's one thing I wouldn't put quotes around. You guys are both athletes, natural born athletes.
What? I want to go to the NFL after this. Like legitimately, just to play like safety and just deck people. No, I swear to God, and I'm about to bring hella ratings to whatever team I'm on.
Where would you want to go if you can go to any team?
Shit, the Browns. Hey. Bring it back. Like, who would you have ever thought I would play for the Cleveland Browns? No, right?
don't know.
That would be crazy.
Football takes.
Bro, you could run a 4.3 40.
My football takes so much.
I could run a 4.3 40.
He's the fastest man on the planet.
I proved it in Mr. Beast Creator Games.
And the Challenger Games.
I caught an Olympic sprinter. And especially the Challenger Games.
No, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, what? I have the size, the power. I can knock people out with one punch. So why can't I play free? Why can't I play free safety?
NFL players be talking shit sometimes, and some of them are in support of you, Patrick Mahomes, like your knockout. But
yeah, that was dope.
Do you think you coming into the NFL would be the equivalent of like when an NFL player says, or a basketball player, or any athlete says, "I'm going to try to box now"?
No, because I played football my whole life.
You had hands. You had. This guy can catch.
One-handed catch.
This guy can catch.
Remember
when was at that flag football game?
Yeah, the flag football.
No,
I was just saying.
Bro, what the fuck?
I played against you.
When I had a one-handed catch over you.
Dog.
Like some sick shit.
That's what you say growing up. If it touches his hands, he catches it.
Yeah, I got.
I can't believe it.
I got hands. Just step into the. Oh!